Welcome to the FCC's online tutorials. This is a guide to using RSS. RSS is commonly considered to stand for Really Simple Syndication. It allows you to subscribe to any content and have all updates to that content sent to you. In most cases, a website will offer one or more RSS feeds, and you, the site visitor, can subscribe to a feed with what is called a RSS reader. We'll begin with a quick introduction to RSS readers and end with an overview of RSS at the FCC's website. There are many choices of RSS readers, most of which are free. You have the option of using a web-based RSS reader or software that you install on your computer. One advantage to web-based readers is that you can use them anywhere you have internet access, including on a computer on which you cannot install new software. One advantage to an RSS reader that you install on your computer is online access. In other words, that you can catch up even if you aren't connected to the internet. Examples of online RSS readers include Google Reader, Blog Lines, My MSN, and My Yahoo. Examples of software that you can install on your computer include RSS Owl, Mozilla Thunderbird, and Microsoft Outlook 2007. A more complete list can be found at the Wikipedia entry for List of Aggregators. For the purpose of this demonstration, we will use Google Reader and RSS Owl. Probably the best way to get to know RSS and its benefits is just to start using it. As you can see, I have subscribed to various news sources, the White House blog, and the Twitter feed for the Federal Communications Commission, as well as others. I will now show you RSS feeds on the FCC's website and how to subscribe to any or all of them. Go to FCC.gov/RSS. That's FCC.gov/RSS. You can also click on the RSS button at the top and bottom of the website. Here, you will see a list of the feeds that the FCC maintains. They are mostly broken down by document type or which office or bureau is the origin of the file. There are also several feeds by which you can follow the agency's social media presence. If, for instance, you want to subscribe to statements by the FCC commissioners, here is what you would do. Right-click on the hyperlink and copy the URL. Go back to your RSS reader and choose to add a new feed. Paste in the URL for the RSS feed. And on the left, you will now see that you are subscribed to the FCC recent releases for statements by the commissioners. Though there's only one right now, this is where RSS really shines. Going forward, you no longer have to regularly check the website for new statements, but rather can just keep an eye on your RSS reader. As you subscribe to more feeds, you'll save time because all your updates are in one place. If, for instance, you were not going to just follow commissioner statements, but also broadband.gov's blog, as well as the YouTube videos that the commission is producing, and the latest tweets in the FCC's Twitter account, the RSS becomes a one-stop resource that is automatically updated as new content is added to any of these sites. Each time, clicking on an item brings up the full entry, as well as allows you to click through and see the original. Now to return to FCC.gov/RSS. Suppose you wanted to also keep up with all of the public notices issued by the agency. This time, though, I will demonstrate using Google Reader. You again copy the link location, click Add a Subscription, paste in, press Add. There you are. That's all there is to it. The advantage of RSS, though, comes with time and adoption. By beginning to use RSS more and more, and keeping an eye on your reader, just like you would your email inbox. When I first add this subscription, I will mark all as read. That way, I'll know going forward that all public notices that I see here have been published in the interim since I last checked. An important advantage of RSS is that it keeps up with all updates since you last checked, even if it's been a long time. So, if you take a 2-week vacation without internet access and then return to work, your RSS feeds will have queued up for you all that's come out since you last checked. No more, no less. This is much more convenient than browsing a website trying to see what looks new to you. With RSS, you can follow news, you can follow your friends' blogs, you can follow feeds of personal or professional interest. It's important to note that most websites have RSS feeds, and that this trend will only continue growing. At the New York Times, you can see their RSS link right here. BBC. Same thing. Almost anything you're currently doing on the internet can be facilitated with RSS. Something else to note is what happens when you simply click on a hyperlinked RSS feed instead of copying its URL. This can often serve the same purpose, though with each web browser, you'll get a different reaction. With Firefox, you actually see the most recent post, and it will also give you several choices from which to choose your reader of choice. Live bookmarks are built in to Firefox and provide an easy and lightweight RSS functionality. As you can see, it is also sensing RSS OWL on my computer. Here is what it looks like in Opera. And in Internet Explorer. You may still find the most convenient way to subscribe to feeds is simply by copying the address of the feed and pasting it into your reader manually. Important examples of FCC feeds are for the blogs at broadband.gov, and openinternet.gov. On both, you can follow news and updates, but you can also subscribe to the comments that are being contributed by the public. If RSS still seems a bit confusing, I recommend searching online for what is RSS, or Beginner's Guide to RSS. Thank you very much, and I hope you'll give the RSS feeds at the FCC's website a chance.